Alright guys, थोड़े ना books की बात करते हैं. The most common question which all these aspirants ask is, क्या books follow करने चाहिए, कितने books follow करने चाहिए, right? और how to go about preparing from these books, in the sense कि books sufficient है, कि जहाँ भी coaching या tuitions जा रहे हैं, वो material sufficient है, दोनों करने चाहिए, तो बहुत confusion. So Pranav, what would you suggest? What would you recommend the students on this?
Well, personally speaking, I would feel ki books matter a lot.
Yeah.
Because the energy you put in books, probably you can't get that complete quality out of materials.
That's right.
Because ultimately books are designed for the globe. Material is designed for, you can say, specific. So it is often biased by teachers.
Mm.
Well, books usually prevent that.
Okay.
And personally, I spent a lot of time on books and avoided material to some extent. Obviously, you have to maintain some problem solving.
Yeah.
If you have your focus on books, then the material you solve will be sufficient.
Okay.
Right. So, and if you want to ask which books, then I'd say for physics, you can go for H.C. Verma, the famous and the most important.
Okay. So, H.C. Verma to karna hai.
That is minimum. मतलब वो complete करके फिर आगे बात करते हैं.
Okay. उसके आगे क्या?
उसके आगे तो फिर you can go for. There are a lot of personally, I followed B.M. Sharma. For class 12th.
Okay.
Because class 12th mein aata hai, you have to have application. And application is something which H.C. Verma does not cover.
Alright.
In chemistry, in class 11th, I covered Pradeep for theory.
Okay.
Pradeep. And for solving the famous physical chemistry as Narendra Awasthi. For organic, we have M.S. Chauhan. And for inorganic, K. Kumar.
Okay. These are the books
These
you
are
followed.
The books I followed.
Alright. And how many books? I mean, sirf yehi books kiye the ki aur liye the. See, I'll tell you why this question. Because students 5 books खरीद लेते हैं, फिर देखते हैं दोस्त कुछ और खरीद रहा है, वो भी खरीद लेते हैं. तो थोड़ा सा वहाँ पर suggest करिए students को कि कितने books खरीदने चाहिए, कितने books करने चाहिए, right?
खरीद लो, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है. Because I have a pile at home which I didn't open. Didn't open. Forget studying regularly. I didn't open. So buying it is all right, but ultimate focus should be one book. Because just an example, suppose you have a book of one author and another author.
Mm-hmm.
Then there are often topics which the first author will cover in the second chapter and forget in the first chapter. And the other one will cover in the first chapter itself. And so just a case in which in the first book you read the first chapter and the second book you read the second chapter. You missed out the topic.
Yeah.
So that's why stick to one book.
Okay. Very, very interesting. Savesh, aapke kya comments hai ispe?
Okay, so I'll talk subject wise. Let's start with like physics. So S.S. ne kaha, H.C. Verma is the most important book. You should read H.C. Verma for theory. बिकॉज लाइक उसमें थ्योरी जो बिल्कुल लाइक करेक्ट थ्योरी है, लाइक कुछ बुक्स में थोड़ा बहुत गलत भी उस पर. एच सी वर्मा आई फील इज द लाइक बेस्ट बुक फॉर थ्योरी एंड कंसेप्ट अच्छे से क्लियर करता है. आफ्टर एच सी वर्मा यू कैन गो ऑन विद द लाइक एम सी क्यू शॉर्ट आंसर्स एंड लाइक द बैक प्रॉब्लम्स. ट्राई टू कम्प्लीट एच सी वर्मा एज मच एज यू वॉन्ट एंड टेक द डाउट्स ऑफ एच सी वर्मा. बिकॉज अगर एच सी वर्मा क्लियर है तो यू नो दैट आपके बेसिक कंसेप्ट क्लियर है. देन यू कैन गो ऑन विद एनी अदर सॉल्विंग मटीरियल लाइक डी सी पांडे और बंसल शीट्स. लाइक दीज आर मीन्स वेरी नाइस मटीरियल्स फॉर सॉल्विंग. ओके, सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट केमिस्ट्री, देन इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री के लिए के कुमार इज अ वेरी नाइस बुक जिसके दो वर्जन आते हैं, जेई मेंस एंड जेई एडवांस्ड. सो यू कैन गो ऑन विद एनी ऑफ देम व्हिच डिपेंडिंग ऑन आपका फोकस क्या है. के कुमार इज अ वेरी नाइस बुक फॉर इनऑर्गेनिक. देन ऑर्गेनिक के लिए लाइक देयर आर टू बुक्स व्हिच आई सॉल्व, हिमांशु पांडे एंड एम एस चौहान. वन थिंग, इफ यू सॉल्व टू बुक्स, फर्स्ट सॉल्व अ बुक कंप्लीटली, लाइक एक चैप्टर बुक से पूरा कर लिया, देन ओनली स्टार्ट द चैप्टर फ्रॉम अनदर बुक. लाइक दोनों बुक साथ साथ करोगे कोई कंप्लीट नहीं होगी, कोई फायदा नहीं होगा. आप दोनों बुक्स की सिर्फ इजी क्वेश्चंस करके छोड़ दोगे. तो पहली बुक एक कंप्लीट करो, हैव अ क्लोजर ऑन दैट, टेक डाउट्स एंड देन स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड बुक, लाइक इन रिवीजन टाइम पे ऐसा कुछ. पर फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री नरेंद्र अवस्थी, बालाजी पब्लिकेशंस, दैट्स अ वेरी नाइस बुक. एक डिसेंट लेवल तक वो काफी अच्छी बुक है, लाइक जे एडवांस तक हो जाता है. फॉर ओलंपियड्स यू नीड डिफरेंट प्रिपरेशन, दैट्स डिफरेंट. फॉर मैथ्स दिस इज अ वेरी सब्जेक्टिव थिंग कि मैथ्स लाइक आई पर्सनली सॉल्व लाइक विनय कुमार, इट्स फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक्स. देन फॉर कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री एंड ट्रिग्नोमेट्री एस एल ओनी एंड these are two books I did. But the thing is, maths is like very vast, so it takes up a lot of time. So depending on that, you can pick up some other books like Arihant. It's a very good book and it has like topic-wise questions. So Arihant is also a very nice book. And maths ke liye, like you can ask your teachers which book to follow or take up the coaching material. But for physics and chemistry, I think this pattern can be followed. Like it is an ideal pattern.
Very interesting. So yaar guys, ye batao. ये जो आपने बुक्स बताए, इज दिस फॉर जे मेन्स और डू यू थिंक दिस इज ऑल्सो सफिशियंट टिल जे एडवांस्ड? व्हाट इज दैट?
दीज बुक्स आर लाइक सफिशियंट फॉर जे एडवांस्ड besides that you can like agree sab ho gaya, then you can go on with a higher level material. But I think they are a good preparation for JEE Advanced. Right. And one thing, don't miss the NCERTs ever, because JEE Advanced mein like NCERT ke ek line utha ke question puch lete hain, especially in chemistry. So even if you don't read the chapter side by side as it is taught, you should complete the NCERT for physics and chemistry at least. Maths ka it's an option, but physics and chemistry ke liye by the end of 12th you should have completed NCERT, because it will help in boards also and JEE Advanced also, JEE Mains also. So NCERT is a must.
So thanks for bringing that point, Savish. NCERT wala. In fact, my next question was on that exactly. Ki NCERT ka kya role hai is puri cheez mein, right? In this entire preparation, many of the students feel that NCERT is just for boards, right? Or JEE Mains or advanced preparation na alag hoti hai, right? But like what you said, it doesn't seem so. So, aap dono se puchna chahunga, and Anand, you too, that what is the role of NCERT? How should student approach NCERT? Kab karna chahiye, kitna karna chahiye? So, I think you, since you answered, you know, I think I'll start with you only. Can you elaborate on this more?
So, chemistry NCERT is very important. You can read it side by side, means as the chapter is taught, or you can read it at the end. But try to read it side by side for chemistry. And reason is, you know, so that you don't miss out on any topic. Maybe ho sakta hai padhaya na wo topic kisi teacher ne, then you can at least have a closure on that chapter ki aap kuch miss nahi hua apka exam point of view se, like board point of view se bhi, advanced point of view se bhi. And inorganic chemistry ke liye baat karoge to I think NCERT is the god thing finally. NCERT pe sare expand karte hain. NCERT is a very good level book for organic, same thing for physics. NCERT mein aisi aisi cheeze hain jo shayad coaching mein bhi nahi padhate, and it's very good book. Like uska jo back problems hai unka level bahut hi zyada acha hai. To physics मतलब करनी चाहिए, like if you don't read it side by side, complete it at the end, because back problems उसकी बहुत अच्छे हैं and extra concepts भी आते हैं, like especially chapters like modern physics, it's amazing. And then maths के लिए it's up to you, like some extra topics के अलावा you can skip NCERT if you want, but like topics like statistics you should complete that.
Pranav, any points on that?
Yeah, I'd say that one of often misconception that students often have would be that chemistry NCERT is easy or it's not a good book.
Low level.
Frankly speaking, I loved chemistry NCERT. It's an amazingly designed book. It covers everything in depth, and the topics in which we don't need to go into depth, it just skims over it. It's a perfectly designed book. So, and personally, I loved reading the NCERT, and reading the NCERT is a must. There is no two opinions on that.
Okay.
You have to read your NCERT completely.
Right.
And
for all the subjects?
For chemistry.
For chemistry.
And for physics, you, like he said, you can cover it at a later stage. Okay. You can actually wait for physics NCERT. But chemistry NCERT, you have to cover side by side. If you leave it for the end, then there's a huge gap you have left in your preparation.
Very, very interesting. Anand, any inputs or any pointers on top of what these guys have said? Ki NCERT ko bachcho ko kaise approach karna chahiye, right? And more importantly, should it be the start point, or should it be the end point, or should it be the revision point?
Yeah, so I think most of the points they have added, they have already commented on. Subject-wise, maths, definitely you can skip NCERT, because if you are preparing for a competition, the level itself goes beyond NCERT at a very early stage, and therefore there are very less things that you will gain out of NCERT in maths, specifically barring the topics like statistics, as Sarvesh told. But in chemistry, definitely it is the starting point. Because it's, as Pranav was mentioning, it's a beautifully written book and you can't miss out anything. You have to cover each and every point there. So, lot of things have been written, you know, in between the lines. You have to read in between the lines, and maybe you have to read it twice, thrice or four times to exactly extract the all the items out of it. So, many a times I also tell students that even the diagram which is mentioned there, you should actually write it down separately, see what is given in the diagram, what is the context of that. For example, P2O5, so how many P and O linkages are there? And if diagram is there, it is important from a competition perspective. So you should note each and everything out of chemistry and prepare a separate note copy for NCERT chemistry. Physics, I felt that a lot of students, they feel difficult when they start with physics. And therefore, HCRMA is a very good starting point in physics. But towards the end, when you have prepared for the entire 11th and 12th, and when you are revising, then you can pick up the NCERT of physics, and you should not leave it. Because as Sarvesh was mentioning, there are a lot of points in NCERT which is not covered anywhere. I have seen a lot of teachers skipping the points, right? So, a lot of points in fluid dynamics and in boxes, in blue boxes, few things are written, right? And they are so very important that in general, we skip it. But exams, they ask questions from there.
Very interesting. So, I think guys, all of you watching, the common theme here is NCERT is extremely critical and important, especially for the subjects of chemistry and to an extent physics as well, right? So, that's lovely.